Support for abortion is dropping across the country. A new NBC News Wall Street Journal survey finds that 52% of Americans say that abortion should be illegal. Some of those people say there do need to be exceptions, but 45% say the procedure should always be illegal. This is a change from just months ago. A similar survey from January found the majority of Americans said abortion should be legal in some form. And while approval of abortion may be dropping, support for gay marriage is on the rise. That same survey finds 53% say gay couples should be able to marry. That's up from 2 points from a December survey. For more on these important social issues facing the country, we turn now to Quinn Hillier. He's a senior fellow at the Center for Individual Freedom. He joins us now from our Washington Bureau. Quinn, let's begin with this new poll about gay marriage. A majority of Americans now say they support legalizing it. What's behind the shift?
Well, you've got more and more young people who are brought up in a new world where the differences between the sexes is minimized, where they're taught that there are almost no differences between the sexes, where they're taught that there's really almost no link between sexual activity and child rearing, where they're taught all sorts of other things that diminish their appreciation for what marriage has been for millennia, for several millennia of human history. And so they start to think of marriage as just being about A, sexual activity, and B, feeling good with somebody at a particular point, rather than seeing it as a lifelong commitment to create a stable family. Right now, the media doesn't even show what a real family is anymore, and so it's a problem. It really is a problem for those who believe in traditional marriage.
A few weeks ago, the Supreme Court heard arguments against California's Prop 8 and the Defense of Marriage Act. A decision is expected this summer. How do you think that's going to play out?
Unfortunately, I think it's going to be a big muddle. I think, okay, you've got two different cases and two different aspects of the homosexual marriage debate. And you've got several different factions on the court wanting to try to, you know, sort of split the difference, split the baby, as it were, pun unfortunately intended. And I think you're going to get one of these or a pair of decisions that have all kinds of permutations and that don't really clarify a lot for most of the people in the country.
The same poll we mentioned earlier finds more Americans are changing their minds about supporting abortion. Are pro-life advocates finally starting to win their fight?
I think there are, and there are indications in states across the nation at the state level of more pro-life legislation passing. Four states recently, I think it was Alabama, I think Virginia, North Dakota, and Arkansas have all had more pro-life legislation passed recently. And I think this shows young people are not averse to arguments about right and wrong. It's just that in some cases, it's not clear to them what right and wrong is, but they like the idea of doing that which is morally right, and they're starting to see just how horrible abortion is, especially when you see cases like this Gosnell case.
Okay, Quinn Hillier, as always, thanks for your insights.
Thank you, Mark. Appreciate it.